victim is Petty Officer Aaron Thomas, 23 years old, served as a gunner's mate on the USS Mahan.
What was he doing out at the park?
CEO said he was an avid outdoor enthusiast. If it wasn't on the ship, he was building campfires.
He go out there with anyone?
Bunkmates said he preferred camping alone.
Two dozen sailors crammed into a single berth. I'd want a little me time, too.
Well, Thomas's minimal security clearance gave him no access to vital intel.
So it's unlikely that he was targeted because of his job in the Navy. Why was he killed?
And why was he killed in the middle of a national park?
No one around for miles to catch him in the act.
All right, Torres, start with this. Who was in that park in the last 72 hours? McGee, license plates, credit cards, anything to give us IDs that we can call.
Gentlemen, I just got off the phone with my counterpart at the National Park Service.
What did the Flat Hat Brigade want?
To team up. And since their man was first in the scene, I agreed. So now this is a joint investigation with ISB agent Winchester.
But it's a Navy victim. No way, man. You tell the NPS to back off and let us do what we do.
Is there gonna be a problem, Agent Parker?
Look, it's just that me and the NPS haven't always seen eye to eye.
About what?
About a mild trespassing allegation.
Define mild.
Golden Gate National Park, summer 2016. It was the biggest western snowy plover mating season in years.
Snowy what?
Bernard alert.
Maybe I climbed a fence with a do not climb sign to get a shot of the nesting area, but this was one for my wall, okay? You understand? This was a framer.
Yeah, until you got caught by the NPS?
And put on a list.
All right, well, you cooperate with Agent Winchester on this case. Maybe we can get you off that list.
Agent Knight is out now at the park with her ISB ex-boyfriend trying to track the killer's trail.
Oh, well, rewind. Agent Knight had some kind of previous personal relation to Agent Winchester.
You need us to define personal?
Palmer, no?
Oh, yeah.
Is that gonna be a problem?
Well, let me put it like this. I know each of Delilah's exes, no problems there, but if Gage Winchester was one of them,
yeah, she could keep that one to herself.
And somebody should give the good doctor a heads up that we'll be seeing a lot more of Agent Winchester.
I don't understand the issue.
Well, I could push back a little harder. The two of them working together is a clear conflict of interest.
Was it a conflict of interest when you were working with your ex-wife 3 months ago? Look, from what I understand, Agent Winchester has a unique skill set that will really aid in this investigation.
The fact that he and Knight were camping together, that doesn't bother you?
Why would them camping together a lifetime ago bother me?
I don't mean camping. I mean...
I know what you meant. But Agents Knight and Winchester are trained professionals. I trust they'll keep things professional out in the field.
Just like you and Knight keep things professional here.
Let's move on to my report.
Well, definitely not bear claw marks.
A 4-inch hunting blade severed the carotid artery, the femoral artery, as well as the inferior vena cava deep inside of his abdomen. Exsanguination would have occurred within minutes.
Killer bled him out efficiently.
The attacker was a 6 foot, 6 foot two, based on the angle of the wounds.
Can we trace a knife?
A 4-inch blade is far too common to narrow it down to a make and model, however.
Oh, can't sneeze at a good however.
The expert lethality of the wounds really got me thinking.
These are the other park murders Winchester was looking into.
All right, the Everglades victim was barbecued in a campfire, while the Smoky Mountains victim was shoved off of a cliff.
Gross. And grosser.
I think I might have found something the other MEs may have overlooked, probably because of the severity of the wounds to the victims' bodies. But I think these injuries were covering up other wounds. I think each one of these is a stab wound. Each one of them had a major artery, each with a 4-inch blade.
Just like our victim.
Yeah, I had Casey scan all of these photos to render a 3D composite image. Now, the angle of the wound would suggest a 6-foot-ish attacker.
Same MO. Could be the same person.
Which would mean that we have a serial killer who's hunting in our national parks.